Our first state bred 2-year-olds were in the limelight at Dover Downs recently as 4 $100,000 Delaware Standardbred Breeders Fund Finals went to post. First up, let's see our Delaware bred Trotting Fillies in action as Disco Soleil took home the winner's share.
101 and 1/5 as they head over toward the backstretch. Making a break also was Royal Locket. They head up the backstretch toward 3/4. Disco Soleil leads by about 2 lengths. Start time is there. Sierra's Choice up into third. Back to fourth goes She Spooky, following Command Today after that costly break down inside Bella's Party Punk. They race toward the far turn with Disco Soleil having a 2-length lead. Start time is there. On the outside, Sierra's Choice. Down inside, She Spooky. 3-wide move coming from Command Today. 132-1. They make the way midway on the final turn, coming toward the top of the stretch, pulling away. Disco Soleil. Disco Soleil by 4. Start time, trying to hold second. Inside, waiting is She Spooky. Out wide is Command Day at the top of the stretch. Disco Soleil is all alone coming through the stretch. It'll be Disco Soleil. Disco Soleil, going to be close for a second now.
Disco Soleil wins easily by 6 lengths in 201-4 for trainer Carlo Policino. The daughter of CR Commando also won her rich final at Harrington in the fall and now dominated at Dover for owner, breeder, and driver Rod Allen.
Congratulations, Rod, and tell me about the race.
Not much to it. It was just getting her out of the gate. Last week she struggled a little bit. Got up on the gate a little early, and she gets a little excited, so I just had to time it, and that all worked out. So the rail was probably a good place for her tonight.
I was watching your wife watch the race, and yes, she was a little bit anxious as well, but she absolutely loves this filly, and she talked about her name, Disco Soleil. So Soleil means sun in French, but the disco part, she actually does some dancing, right?
I guess. I don't know where she comes up with these names, but that's all right with me, as long as they're good ones.
So in the stall, she says she doesn't really weave. Is there like some kind of choreographic moves or something she does?
If you got peppermints, she'll do just about anything. Peppermints are her favorite. I think we're going to have to cut her off for a little while.
And you're also the breeder, so tell me about her breeding a little bit.
This mare's dam lines up perfect with Commando, the pedigree does, and she has had quite a few. She's now 17 years old. I'm going to have to find another mare to breed to him, but the combination works good, and she's had every one of them go to the races and quite a few that done well. So,
now, although you're down as owner, we all know who is the boss here, okay? It's Dawn, right? So tell me about, she got a big present when Disco Soleil won the last $100,000 final. Is that correct?
Yeah, I put my foot in my mouth. I didn't think I could actually win the race, and I said, this might be your new car. And in the winner's circle, she was all smiles. How can you say no to that? So, you know, that's the way it ended up. She's got a nice new car. I drove it for the first time, actually, today. She's had it about 2 months.
So do you get a new car after this win?
Highly doubtful.
Okay. Maybe a tractor or something, you know, we'll see, right?
A lawnmower, yeah.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Next up, let's see our freshman pacing fillies with Roddys at it again, scoring the big win in her division.
Field races into the clubhouse, turn on their way toward the half. Vista Mista leads the Lady Sheriff. Golden Wiglet is there. Roddy's at it again, his fourth. Then there's a gap back to Miss Giggles. Racing on the outside, that's Aniki. Next comes Carolina Shag and a big gap back to Lily's Puddle Jumper, 56 4/5. Racing up the backstretch with Vista Mista leading by a length and a half. The Lady Sheriff is there. Roddy's at it again on the outside into third. Golden Wiglet back to fourth. Aniki follows in fifth. Down inside sixth is Miss Giggles. Field races by 3/4. The leader is Vista Mista, 125-2. Midway on the final turn, Vista Mista, the Lady Sheriff. Roddy's at again on the outside toward the rail, Golden Wiglet. Then it's Aniki and Miss Giggles. They're at the top of the stretch now. Vista Mista joined by Roddy's at it again. They come off the turn. Roddy's at it again. Has gone up and gotten the lead as they straighten away. Roddy's at it again, but here comes the Lady Sheriff. They come through the stretch farther out. Here's Golden Wiglet. Golden Wiglet and Roddy's at it again at the wire. Very close.
There were three right there at the wire, but it was Roddys at it again, winning by a nose in 156 with Art Stafford Jr. at the controls. The Delaware Director of Finance, Rick Geisenberger, was in victory lane with this daughter of Roddys Bags again to present the winning trophy to owner Katie Killen and trainer Tim Torbert.
Tell me about the race, because it was super close and you were not the favorite.
No. Our filly was fighting a bunch of sickness the last couple weeks, and just got lucky, and it worked out in our favor. That was all.
What were you thinking coming down the stretch?
Well, I thought if Montrell's horse got locked in there a little bit longer, that I had a pretty good shot. I thought that was our biggest contention at the time, but Bart's filly raced super and was charging really hard late. So I thought once we headed him, we had a pretty good shot, but you never know.
It's really exciting. I mean, this is the final. And doesn't your girlfriend own her?
Yes, she does. Yep. First horse she ever owned.
Whoa.
Here's luck, huh?
Whoa, my gosh. So what did she say after the race?
She was pretty much in awe. Just like couldn't believe it. She said, I just need to be pinched.
So did you pinch her?
Very excited. Oh,
What about her personality? I mean, she's two, so.
She's pretty grumpy. You know? Like, I like the fillies like that. I like them to have a little attitude to them. We've had a lot of luck over the years with those kinds, so that's about how she is.
All right. So when they're grumpy and maybe want to nip at you and not...
It probably ain't nothing, but I just feel that they got a little fight to them and they will race a little tougher. That's just always been my thought.
I like that. I like that theory. Now, she gets time off now? Is she on vacation?
She's out in the field 3 to 4 weeks, I guess, depending on... the weather and this and that. I don't want to leave her out too long, because then you got to fight the weather and whatnot to get her back by, I think we got to be back in the middle of March.
Okay, well, we will see you for the next round when she's a three-year-old. Exciting.
Hoping so.
Moving on for more action, it was Embrace the Grind, winning the DSBF final in our two-year-old Trotting Colts division.
1 minute flat for the half as the field begins their trip up the back stretch on the way toward three quarters. On top by almost two is Embrace the Grind, make it a length and a half. That's just as striking. Then there's a gap back to Dr. Grinch. Next is Getting Ziggy with it. They go toward the final turn. Embrace the Grind, a two-length lead now into that far turn. Embrace the Grind, just as striking, about five or six lengths. Up into third now, Getting Ziggy with it. Dr. Grinch is all done. Here comes Go Jet 'em up into fourth, 1:30 and 2/5. They make their way toward the top of the stretch, and it's Embrace the Grind by 3.5. Embrace the Grind, just as striking. Here's Getting Ziggy with it on the outside, trying to get up into second, going after the leader as they straighten away. Embrace the Grind by 4 lengths, coming through the stretch. Getting Ziggy with it takes over second as they come toward the wire. It'll be Embrace the Grind to win easily. Embrace the Grind by 5. Then it's going to be Getting Ziggy with it, just as striking, in 2:02.
Embrace the Grind crossed the finish line 6 lengths ahead of his rivals as he scored in 2:02 with reinsman John Roberts. Delaware Secretary of Agriculture Michael Skuse joined the connections of the Keystone Activator Sun in the winner's circle to present owner trainer Bobby Glassmeyer with the DSBF final trophy.
Bobby, you just said that you were a little bit anxious before the race. Is that true?
Yes, I was pretty anxious in the final at Harrington. He ran behind the gate and cost us the race. So, yeah, I'm definitely anxious.
Well, he was definitely the favorite going in, and he looked the part. He really looked fabulous.
Yeah, he's a pretty good horse. The only mistake he's ever made was that day at Harrington. He was a little sick last week, so made sure to take care of him. He was good again tonight.
How did you get him? He's a Keystone Activator, right?
Yeah, it was one of the horses that Lee Raymer and Tyler were selling when they were selling their horses last year. And I went and looked at him and didn't like him that much, but bought him anyway. So, yeah, I just wanted to get a colt. I already had a filly, so he was really the only thing left to buy, so I bought him. Got a great mare. He's out of a nice mare. That everything she throws is a good horse, so I took a shot on it.
I saw you talking to Jonathan after the race, so tell me, what did Jonathan say about this horse during this final? He looked so super.
Yeah, he said he was just wrapped up. He said he's could have just sat outside the whole mile and kept going, but that's why he was being so cautious in the first turn, just kind of making sure everybody got settled and then went to the front.
He's now had 6 starts and 5 wins. What makes him a good horse?
I think he was just born that way. He's been a good horse to work with since day one. He doesn't really do anything wrong. He's very smart. That's why I was so surprised when he made the break at Harrington. You know, but he's perfect. He doesn't do anything wrong, ever.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Finally, we'll check out the winner of the Pacing Colts and Geldings, and it was the freshman standout, Chillaxin Away, taking home the winner's share.
57-2, 30 2/5. They go to the back stretch, and leading it is Chillaxin Away, followed by Dashiki. It's about 2.5 lengths to Mr. Big Wig, racing on the outside, Son of the Lynx toward the rail. That's number to count. Another 2 lengths to Air Spinder, who's going by a wiggle and a giggle. They race toward the final turn. Chillaxin Away with a comfortable lead. Dashiki right there. 2.5, Mr. Big Wig. Number to count inside, 3 wide, Air Spinder. Son of Lynx between horses, 1/26 3/5. They make the way over toward the top of the stretch, and Chillaxin Away has to deal with Dashiki, who moves to the outside. Mr. Big Wig is third. They come off the turn and straighten away, and pulling away is Chillaxin Away. Chillaxin Away by 2.5, coming to the wire. Chillaxin Away is in front. Then it's going to be Dashiki and Mr. Bigwig in 154-2.
Chillaxin Away went from gate to wire for the 154-2 victory, and at the controls was Tim Tietrich, the 2-year-old son of Roddy's Bags Again, who also won his DSBF final at Harrington in the fall, is owned by Joanne Looney King and trained by her husband, Jim King Jr. And we talked to him about this youngster's strong performance.
He was just really good. Between the races, he had gotten a little sick. So for the eliminations, I wasn't quite as confident as I was tonight. And tonight, we had him prepared.
How about his personality? What's he like at the barn?
He's a little turd. I don't know if that flies or not, but that's kind of what all horsemen know what that means. Yep, he's just very playful. He likes to play. Yeah.
How did you get him? You had him from the very beginning, like broke him and everything?
We did. We have his mother. We've had several half-brothers and sisters. His sire was also owned and trained by Delaware people. The brood mare, Shake Away, she was a really good mare right here, raced in the top classes, and we just like him. Yeah.
What's he doing now? What's he up to, like, after tonight?
Well, after tonight, we'll shut him down a little bit and get ready for the next series of races, which are starting March. And I'm sure I'll start him before then, but he'll get a little time.
What did Timmy say to you after he got off the bike tonight?
He says kind of special to have one you bred and trained and owned a mother and everything. He said he was all that. Yeah.
Congratulations and great job by our 2-year-old class of the Delaware Standardbred Breeders Fund champions. We'll see those pacers and trotters back for more stakes action on our first state ovals in 2019.